So good afternoon, everybody. So till the time they're putting up the presentation, basically, we focus on coal gasification as the... Okay, so why I write innovative solution on coal gasification is the point I want to put to the chair, Mr. Dr. Sinha. You see, coal gasification is a very talked subject, but very few people are actually implementing it. As my friend Mr. Venkatraman also explained, that in China, and in South Africa, because of their own peculiar need of energy security, they have worked on it. And we as India, because we have coal, we should have also been part of those two countries in promoting coal gasification and getting fuel and liquids out of coal. But we talk, we don't implement. As Dev Energy, we have been doing that implementation part from last 15 years. What we have been doing, is we focus on coal gasification for only fuel which is industrial heating. And this, we have been able to do it with our partners in China, which is one of the largest gasification companies in fixed bed gasification. And we have done around 180 systems in India right now and in various industries like steel, ceramic, aluminium, zinc, wherever the industry requires the product to be heated in a furnace. So we supply coal gas to replace expensive fuel. Right. Now, why is innovation required? It's because the gasification technologies in the Western world almost died after Second World War because of natural gas. Natural gas becomes so cheap that most of the technologies which were discovered there by Lurgi and Sasol and most of other Czechoslovakian companies, they didn't make it to the Chinese and the Indian domain. And so today, if you have to go for technology, you have to go to China to understand what is the right technology available for what type of coals. Then Indian coal. There's a lot of coal quality variation, so therefore you have to come up with a technology which addresses our own particular needs of coal variation, quality, both in terms of ash, in terms of caking index, in terms of sizing, a lot of other issues. Then the furnace OEMs are unwilling to convert to coal gas. So if the furnace is designed on furnace oil, propane, LPG, natural gas, the OEMs are not interested in converting to coal gas. So then that designing part, that conversion also you have to do yourself. Then there are safety and environment issues. So all these need to be addressed by the implementer of the project themselves. There are no ready packages available for this, which has been the real hindrance in implementation of these technologies. So we have done it over the last 15 years and we have replaced... So this is one of the examples I quote, is the straight gate pellet plant. We have replaced 100% oil and there is no backup fuel. Energy efficiency, we are able to convert 90% of coal energy into gas. So this is on a fixed bed platform, this is the largest number we can achieve. Then we have done very large plants, high pressure plants. So we have been able to overcome most of these hurdles. These are some of our achievements. Most of these are India's first. Why? Because you have to take the risk and you have to implement the first plant for that particular industry to then adopt it as a standard technology. So that hurdle we have slowly overcome over the years. So what is the core technology? The core technology is fixed bed gasifier, wherein you gasify the volatiles in the coal separately as an upstage gas and you convert the carbon into carbonized gas, which is a mixture of CO, H2 and methane in a separate layer. So there are two stages of gasification and two types of gas are recovered through this gasification process. And then these two gases are taken through a cleaning process and cooling process. You clean these gases of tars, dust, moisture, and then you mix them and then you increase the pressure as per the required furnace, you desulfurize them. So this gas then becomes almost equivalent to natural gas or propane or LPG can be used in any of the furnaces that are actually designed on cleaner fuels. So our gas can be actually equivalent to any of these fuels. This is one of our latest plant we have done. This is a glass furnace. This is one of the largest container glass companies, Hindustan Glass. We have converted their glass kiln into coal gas. This is one of the world's first coal glass kiln working on coal gas. These are straight gate power plant, pellet plants. These are working on coal gas. Both these examples, the OEMs, which are the technology providers for the pellet plant, refused in black and white on a letterhead that this cannot be converted into coal gas. Still, the promoters took the risk and they empowered us to change the burners, to change the combustion system, exhaust system, and install the gasifier. And we were able to achieve 100% coal gas conversion in these plants. This is a furnace for making TMT bar. This is one of the largest installations of coal gas in India. This is 100,000 meter cube of coal gas being produced per hour. These are 10 modules. Almost 10 million tons of long products are made on our gasifiers. These are some of the tile plants. So why I put up is to explain that the gas is so clean that it can be used to make decorative tiles. So these are the large brands which are making tile. Kajaria is one of the largest in India. They make their decorative tiles on our coal gas. So and the temperatures required in the furnace are to be maintained in plus minus 1 degree, zone-wise. So that's the level of control, consistency, reliability we can provide from these plants. So I am trying to highlight what we have already done. Now, what need to be done is the next step, which is that fixed bed has some constraints, that you can only use sized coal. And you can only use hard coal, so lignite and soft coals cannot be used. And so there is a lower carbon conversion of 85 to 90%. So then the solution is a fluidized bed gasifier, which is the next level of gasifier we are trying to promote. The technology is proven in China. It's a fluidized bed gasifier wherein you use coal and water in the fluidized bed reactor, and then you produce a gas which is cleaned through a subsequent cleaning process and used as fuel. So this, there are three plants which are right now operational in alumina calciners in China, running successfully, can be adopted in Indian environment perfectly for lignite and coals which are lighter and high VM coals. So these are some of the advantages of CFB gasification technology. And these technologies can be adopted to create a cheaper alternative to fuels being used for industrial heating anywhere in India. So just I'm closing by requesting Chair to look at this. What is really, and I put this slide in all my presentations, is as a gasification company, what we really need from the forum is that there should be some way wherein we can standardize the technologies, we can certificate the technology so that the buyers and investors of the technology can look at whatever is available on the table with confidence and have a forum wherein we move from talking to doing. Thank you.